The product rule, level 1. In the previous videos, we learned that the derivative of a sum and or difference of functions was equal to the sum and or difference of the derivative of the individual functions. The next question we should ask is if this pattern also works for the product of two functions. In other words, is the derivative of a product of two functions equal to the product of the derivatives of the functions? Let's test this out with the following functions. Let f of x equal x cubed and g of x equal x raised to the power of 6. The product of these two functions is equal to x raised to the power of 9, and the derivative of this function is equal to 9x raised to the power of 8. Now let's verify the right side of this expression. So we go ahead and take the derivative of f of x and g of x as follows. Now, if we were to multiply them, we should obtain 9x raised to the power of 8. But, unfortunately, we obtain something completely different, in this case, 18x raised to the power of 7. This means that this expression does not hold. In other words, the derivative of a product is not the product of the derivatives. It turns out that in order to find the derivative of functions formed by multiplication, we have to make use of the product rule. The product rule says that the derivative of a product of two functions is the first function times the derivative of the second function, plus the second function times the derivative of the first function. In prime notation, the product rule can be written as the derivative of f times g equals f times g prime plus g times f prime. Remember, the functions f and g have to be differentiable. Also notice that it really does not matter which function you assign as your f of x and which one you assign as your g of x. As long as you're consistent with your choices, everything will work out. We can also rewrite the product rule as follows. F prime of x times g of x plus f of x times g prime of x. Some students prefer this version because it generalizes easily to products of three or more functions. For instance, the product rule can be extended to cover products involving more than two functions. For example, if f, g, and h are differentiable functions of x, the derivative will be equal to f prime of x times g of x times h of x plus f of x times g prime of x times h of x plus f of x times g of x times h prime of x. Notice that the derivative or prime symbol alternates between the functions. This only works if you keep the order of the functions consistent. Keep in mind that the derivative of a product of two functions is not, in general, given by the product of the derivatives. Alright, with that said, let's see the product rule in action and go over some examples. Find the derivative of r of x equals x cubed times e to the x. The first thing you should notice is that we have a product of two functions. In this case, we have the power function x cubed and the exponential function. Since we have a product of two functions, we can find the derivative by making use of the product rule. In order to apply the product rule, we need to decide which function is going to be the first function, in this case, f of x, and which one will be the second function, in this case, g of x. Keep in mind that it really does not matter which function you assign as your f of x and which function you assign as your g of x. It is totally up to you. Just make sure you apply the product rule correctly once you made your decision. For this example, I will assign x cubed as f of x and e to the x as g of x. With this assignment, we go ahead and apply the product rule. So we take f of x, our first function, and multiply it by the derivative of g of x, the second function. Then we add the product of g of x and the derivative of f of x. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the final derivative equal to x cubed times e to the x plus 3 times e to the x times x squared. We can also rewrite this expression by factoring out an x squared times e to the x term. In any case, both forms are acceptable expressions for the derivative. Alright, let's try the next example. find the derivative of r of x equals e to the x over the square root of x. Notice that in this example, we have a quotient of two functions. At first glance, it seems that we cannot use the product rule to find the derivative of this function. It turns out that we can actually apply the product rule to this function. All we need to do is to rewrite the expression into a product rule-friendly form. In order to accomplish this, we can rewrite the radical in the denominator as x raised to the power of negative 1/2, as follows. Now we can go ahead and apply the product rule. I will assign e to the power of x as my f of x, the first function, and assign x raised to the power of negative 1/2 as my g of x, the second function. Remember, it really does not matter which function you assign as your f of x and g of x. As long as you're consistent with the product rule, everything will work out. Applying the product rule, we obtain the following expression. The first function times the derivative of the second function plus the second function times the derivative of the first function. Simplifying and rewriting the expression, we obtain the following for the derivative. E to the x over the square root of x minus e to the x over 2 times the square root of x cubed. Keep in mind that you might need to rewrite an expression so that you can apply a specific differentiation rule. Alright, let's try a slightly more challenging example. Find the derivative of r of x equals e to the x times the quantity x squared minus 2x. Here we have a product of two functions. So let's go ahead and use the product rule. Let's assign e to the x as our f of x and assign the quantity x squared minus 2x as our g of x. Next, we find the derivative by applying the product rule. So we take the first function and multiply it by the derivative of the second function, and add the second function and multiply it by the derivative of the first function. Notice that in order to take the derivative of g of x, we need to apply the sum rule and power rule. Having applied the product rule, we go ahead and simplify the expression. Here we can factor out an e to the x term. This leaves us with the following. Then, it is just a matter of simplifying the expression inside the brackets. Doing that yields the final derivative equal to e to the x times the quantity x squared minus 2. Okay, now let's try finding the derivative of a product of polynomials. Find the derivative of p of x equals the quantity x plus 3 times the quantity x squared minus 5x plus 2. I hope you recognize this function. This was the last function we worked on from the previous video. We can actually find the derivative of this function by using the product rule. Let's go ahead and assign the binomial as our f of x and the trinomial as our g of x. Next, we go ahead and apply the product rule. So we take the first function and multiply it by the derivative of the second function, and add the second function times the derivative of the first function. Next, we go ahead and FOIL the expression on the left. Then we go ahead and simplify the expression by combining like terms. Doing that yields the final answer equal to 3x squared minus 4x minus 13. This is the same answer that we got in the previous video. Notice that we could also find the derivative of this function by distributing the binomial and then taking the derivative of each term, like we did in the previous video. Either method would generate the same expression. Alright, let's try the final example. Find the derivative of p of x equals the quantity x cubed minus x times the quantity x squared plus 2 times the quantity x squared plus x minus 1. Notice that we have three functions being multiplied. One way we can find the derivative is to apply the product rule by assigning the product of two functions as our f of x, and assign the third function as our g of x. Then you would just carry out the product rule with these assignments. Taking this approach would force you to apply an additional product rule when trying to find the derivative of f of x. There's really nothing wrong with finding the derivative in this way. I actually encourage you to find the derivative in this manner, so you can practice applying the product rule multiple times. We can also find the derivative by using the product rule extended for more than two functions. In this case, we would need to assign three functions as our f of x, g of x, and h of x. For this problem, we will assign f of x to be the first binomial, g of x the second binomial, and the trinomial as our h of x. Then, it is just a matter of writing all the functions, making sure that we alternate the derivative to each distinct function as follows. Doing that, we obtain the following derivative of the expression. Technically, we are done. This crazy-looking polynomial is our derivative. If you like, you can go ahead and simplify the expression by distributing and collecting like terms. But there is really no need to do that. If for some reason you want to simplify because you want to practice your distribution and collecting like term skills, the resulting polynomial you should obtain is as follows. 7x raised to the power of 6 plus 6 times x raised to the power of 5 plus 4x raised to the power of 3 minus 9x squared minus 4x plus 2. Note that you can also just distribute the expressions in the beginning and then apply the derivative term by term. That would also yield the correct answer. But for expressions that are not polynomials, you want to use the product rule extended for more than two functions. Alright, and that is the product rule in a nutshell. In our next video, we will go over more challenging examples involving the product rule.